Just by doing this and then getting your brush and just going crazy and just swiping it all over your face like this. We're just gonna get some concealer and we're gonna just pop it all here. And then we're gonna go ahead and put some here. A massive rim. Like, what have you been up to? What have you been doing? Do you know what I mean? Like, this is not a look. Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I hope you are well. If you are new here, hi, my name is Chelsea and welcome to my channel. Please hit that subscribe button. So today I thought we'd do a little bit of a different, more light-hearted video and we're gonna do how not to do your makeup. Now, this is in no way me being judgmental. I have learned a lot of this stuff from my own experiences with makeup and things that I've done wrong over the years. So I thought it'd be fun to do this video and then talk about perhaps ways that you can actually, you know, correct it or maybe a different way of doing it slightly better so that you achieve better results. So without further ado, let's just jump straight in. So the first thing I'm gonna talk about is foundation. Foundation that doesn't match. And yeah, we've all been there. We've all got like a favorite foundation. Perhaps we haven't got our tan any longer and we can't use our product any longer and we love it so much that we just use it anyway. So this foundation is way too dark for me. So let's go ahead and apply it. So yeah, as you can see, it's just got more of a pinky tone as well. So foundation undertones are really important and it's took me a really long time to learn that. So yeah, the camera's not picking it up that bad, but this foundation is way too dark for me. So another way that you can resolve that if you don't want to get rid of your favorite foundation is by using foundation drops. So you can get these in a darker shade and also in a lighter shade. So this is the Revolution Pro Foundation Drops. So all you do is put your foundation on your hand, add a couple of drops and then mix it in with your brush and it comes out a different color, like so much better. So as you can see, that's just lightened the foundation and now it is more natural and more to my actual shade. So you can see the difference there straight away. So you don't have to stop using your foundation. You don't have to go ahead and buy a darker shade and a lighter shade in every single foundation. And it's really good. Now, another thing that's like my pet peeve and that I see a lot of is people that don't blend their foundation onto their neck. So they literally have this beautiful harsh line of color, like you can see here. And it's really important just to make sure to take the foundation down. I normally take the foundation down to about here, just so that I know that I'm pretty safe. But yeah, we're gonna leave that beautiful line on this side. So we've got a nice line. The next thing I want to talk about is concealer. Now, again, I have been known to do this in the past. I do sometimes do it, it's just habit. And that is applying over the top concealer. So I'll show you exactly what I mean. So we're just gonna get some concealer and we're gonna just pop it all here. And then we're gonna go ahead and put some here. So we're also gonna put some here, we're gonna put some here. And then yeah, we'll just put some here. And then we're gonna blend that in. This is how you get that kind of cakey look. So as I say, the camera's not picking it up at the moment. I'm looking pretty flawless because of all the lights, but I will show you guys footage at the end so you can see what it looks like in natural daylight. It's amazing how studio lighting can really make makeup look amazing. The amount of times I've done my makeup on camera with all of these studio lights, and then I've gone into the natural light and I'm like, I can't go out like this. I've got to take my makeup off. So although it may look amazing to you guys right now, I will have live footage at the end to show you. What you kind of basically should do with your concealer. Now, I haven't got any blemishes. I have, that's a lie. I've got a blemish there, so we'll pop it there. And then you kind of want to just do little dots like that, but try and do a little dot because what this does is it controls the amount of concealer that you're putting on, so you're not putting on too much. And then when it comes to blending as well, it just makes your job so much easier. But also this helps put the concealer in the right place because you're not having to over blend. So this will actually take it right up under the eye, which is where I need this concealer to go. And this also stops creasing, it stops it from looking cakey. So you can already see the difference, I think, in these concealers. Like, this side's so cakey. You can see how cakey, and it hasn't even covered that bit, see? Whereas this side is much more flawless, and it's also covered everything much better just by using less. You would always think that more is more, but actually, sometimes, less is more. So, setting powder. Now, Let's talk about translucent powder, because again, this is something I see all the time. People going over the top with translucent powder. And this is all very well, as I say, that's fine if you're taking pictures, you're doing photography, you've got studio lighting. But in the day, you can see that like a mofo. So, for example, people go like this, putting all that on, so much beautiful powder. So what I like to do is take a little bit of product. So I'm still putting a decent amount of product on, but I'm literally just going to blend that in. And I will only apply this with a sponge where I tend to get oily. Then what I will do is take a powder brush, still using the translucent powder, and just lightly go over the rest of the face. So you don't need to be heavy going in with that sponge. It's just nice and light. And this way, this will stop you from looking cakey. It stops too much product sitting on your skin and just gives you a nice kind of natural, not over the top look. Just by doing this and then getting your brush and just going crazy and just swiping it all over your face like this. Not only do I now look really pale because obviously the color payoff, but I've got patches. So I've got a nice orange line here. Again, I'll make sure you guys can see it at the end. I've got a nice kind of what almost looks like a wrinkle here because the powder sat in there. And then my face just looks really textured. There's a lot of blotchiness. So yeah, whereas this side is a lot more smoother. Brows. Now, the importance behind brows. There's a reason why a lot of thought goes into brows. So the first thing is picking your right colour. Now, again, something I personally don't think looks very nice is when, for example, you have someone, say, with really light blonde hair like myself, even without a root, let's just take it to the extreme, and they basically have like black eyebrows. I see a lot of people using really dark colours. This, for example, is too dark for me. It's also got a chestnut shade in. And what I also see is like people really going in, and what they do is they bring the brow like right here as well. Has anybody else noticed that that was a thing for a while? And then just really making the brows really over the top. Brows on fleek. Whereas I'm gonna use the same pencil. This isn't my favorite pencil, to be honest. I don't even really like this pencil. But if you hold the pencil at the end, you'll get a lot lighter of an effect. If you hold it closer, and this is the same with makeup brushes, you get a more harsh consistency. So if you're looking to blend out lightly or, you know, go in lightly, you need to hold the product at the end. And I'm just gonna follow my natural brow shape. Now, again, this is gonna be different for everyone because there may be people that perhaps don't have a lot of brow hair, so I get it. I used to actually do the opposite. When I was in school, I used to draw my eyebrows really thin, so I would shave this half of my brow off. This is not a joke, this is real. I would shave this half of my brow off and then I would draw on the ends really thin, and I don't even know why I did it. And honestly, guys, it took me forever. Like, my brows only grew back probably when I was like 19. This is another thing as well. Like, sometimes my brows aren't fully filled in. You can see that I still have some gaps, but that's to me far more natural than going, oh, I've got a gap there. You can see, let me fill that right in. So we're gonna move on to eyeshadow, taking my good old Lorac palette. The first thing I would say with eyeshadow is just blending in general. What I see a lot of is people take a big brush, so like a big fluffy brush, a dark color, wanting to get it right in the crease, and they do this. That's too much. Like, there's no, it's took up way too high. What you need to do, even if you use a big brush, and a trick that I learned, again, I'm gonna use the same brush so you don't think I'm fooling you, is to put your head straight when you are looking in the mirror, put the brush right in the crease, and then use really small movements. But just really push the brush into the crease. And what that will make sure that you're doing is that you're not overspreading that product. Like, do you see the difference? It just focuses the brush in that specific area. And a little thing for me as well is once you've done your eyeshadow, take a clean brush, to go over it, we are going to talk about mascara. Now, again, there's not really any pet peeves when it comes to mascara. The only thing I want to talk about is something that I used to do, which really annoys me. So have you ever seen people do that have done their mascara and they've pressed it against their face, or they've done their mascara and they haven't let it dry? It's like, you know when you do your mascara and then you sneeze, but it's like they've left it there. I used to do this in school. Again, it was just from putting on tons of mascara, not letting it dry, looking down or whatever. Like, if I look down now and blink, do you see that? Have you ever had that when you're talking to someone and you can see it and you're like, I really want to tell you it's there, but I feel rude? If you notice that happens, you've got a couple of options. You can take foundation or concealer on a brush and just buff away. As you can see, I've just buffed away that little section there. What I like to do is just take a cotton bud, a dry cotton bud, and just swoosh it in. The only downside with that is if you've already done your foundation, it can cause like a difference. So I do think this is better method. I'm not going to take it all off because obviously we want the end result, but like if I do it here, for example, and it just takes that away without actually, you know, taking off the makeup. Oh my god, my car alarm's going off. So now we're gonna move on to contour. This is one of my favorite things. I love talking about contour. I'm gonna tuck my hair away so you can see my face. Now, the first thing with contour is getting the color right for contour. There are so many brands. I feel like it's getting better over time, but there's brands that release contour shades that are really orange. Contour is supposed to shadow. It is supposed to define, and in order to shadow, you need an ashy shade. This as a contour shade, which is like an orangey color. Again, it's not looking very orange on camera, but you'll see what I mean in a second. Like if I were to compare it to this one, you can see there's orange tones in it, and that's what's gonna not look very nice as a contour color. Do you see that? Now, something again with contour is when you see people who draw a line like this, they do the line above as well. I've seen this all the time. Let's contour the jawline, but we're going to contour it on the jaw, like above the jawline. Yeah, and then they'll take the same brush and again, they'll just kind of blend it like this. And you get like a really harsh line. And this does happen. I've seen it. Like, I've seen people do it. So for under the jawline, something I'd always recommend. When you're drawing, put your teeth together. So when you put your teeth together and stick your jaw out, you can really see where those lines need to go. Now, what you should be doing is doing a triangular shape under, so physically, like if I bend down under, not on, under. And you need to bring it up all the way behind the ear to get that actual jawline. Contour, if you want, you can use this method where you kind of connect from the ear to the mouth. You can do fishy face, one of my personal favorites. But what you basically want to do is do a very small, so we're not coming down to here, very small line that comes down. And as you're using the brush, you want to be blending it out with the brush. So you don't want to be drawing the line and then going back in and in circular motions. I find if you do circular motions, and again, remember about holding the end of the brush, that it just blends a lot nicer. What I like to do is go ahead with a powder brush, and again, just use circular motions to blend that out. Now, when it comes to blending out the sides, use very light circular motions. But what you also want to do is go upwards. You don't want to drag that contour down, because if you do that, it defeats the object. You'll end up, like if I do it here, you'll end up just moving the product all over the face and then you're losing that contour line. Now, if you ever do find contour too harsh, like you've overdone the contour, which we all have, just go in with your powder on the brush and that will just lighten it a little bit, and it'll also just help to blend it. See how that looks more defined in comparison to this side. Highlight is different for everyone. I talk about this in all of my videos. It's really tricky for someone very much like contour to sit and say, this is where you should contour, this is where you should highlight. Because yes, there is kind of an idea of to that, but also it's gonna depend where the light hits you naturally. And I see a lot of people really get highlight on their brush. And they just go wild. They draw a solid line here, solid line. But something I would recommend to make it easier, first of all, a fan brush. A fan brush is fantastic for the sides of the face because they really focus the product on the actual cheekbone. So the whole idea of highlight is to bring out this cheekbone. When you're drawing a massive line like that, you're technically not really highlighting the cheekbone, you're just highlighting the entire face. And I've had it before where I've took a photo and where I've got highlight all down here, my cheeks look fatter, they look more fuller. It defeats the object of the contour because it's highlighting those bits. You don't want to be highlighting bits that you've contoured. So I tend to just bring it round, and what I do just to make it look a little bit more natural so that you haven't got a harsh line is I just bring it in almost like this sort of shape. I just think that looks so pretty. For the nose, rather than going ahead and just putting the brush on, I'd always recommend doing it with your fingertip because it just gets way more specific. If I take my fingertip, I can really just focus it straight on the tip rather than going crazy and just having a load of highlighter and looking like you've snorted highlight. Okay, so finally lipstick. Now again, this is a trend I think, and a lot of people love this trend, but for me personally, I just think it looks awful. And that is taking a nude lip liner, a dark nude. So I'll show you. Quite messily, as you can tell. And then taking like the lightest color lipstick they can find. Doing that. There's no blend. And do you know what? It's amazing because I see, kind of reminds me of like back in the day when we used to like, when we were at school, okay, I'm talking back in the day, we used to get foundation and put foundation on our lips. And this is kind of what this reminds me of, except you've just got like a massive rim. Like, what have you been up to? What have you been doing? Do you know what I mean? Like, this is not a look. Say for example, you've only got a light lipstick and a dark lip liner in your collection. For whatever reason, you have nothing else. Even just taking the lip liner and just lining the sides, like so, and sort of smudge it all together, it gives you more of a contour. Now, again, I still don't think this looks great, personally, because I just think the lip liner is way too dark. And really, what you should do is apply the lip liner all over the lips first with the darker color, and then take the lipstick and just put it in the middle, like the centers. But I still think that looks way better than just having the lightest color possible with the darkest lip liner. So this is the finished makeup tutorial. So let me know what you guys think. Have you come across anything like this? Have you seen anyone with makeup like this, these kind of makeup mistakes? I will insert some footage now from my iPhone so you can see how awful this side really does look. Give me a thumbs up for fun videos like this, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. And this is the side that we didn't. You can just see how awful it is. It's a look, right?